I don't know how to start a video, but I'm Hootless, and this is Hoot Reviews BalanCity, which is a... It's kind of like a city-building game in 2D, except you're building it on a platform that can and will topple over if you put too much weight on one side. It's actually, like, surprisingly fun. It's... As of this recording, and up until... What day is that? Up until Monday of next week, the 16th of October, the game's actually on sale on Steam for 90% off. It's only 80 cents right now. Normally it's $8. So if you like it, if you like the idea of it, then go check it out because it is on sale for a week. Which is, like, serendipitous. I didn't know it was on sale, actually, when I decided to record this. Anyways, my subjective score, 4 out of 5 stars. It's fun, but it's very difficult. You know, it's really easy to accidentally play something that's too heavy, and then everything just goes away, and it's pretty hard to recover from that. It really reminds me of those old, like, tower stacking games. I don't remember the names of them. I know it's not Sim Tower, but something along those lines. Mechanical scoring, I gave it 8.625 out of 10, or, you know, 9 out of 10, or 4.5 stars. Breakdown is graphics, 10 out of 10. It's got beautiful, like, pixelated graphic things and a UI that really fits with everything else. The sound, 10 out of 10. It's pleasant and unobtrusive for both music and sounds with no voice work to ruin or, you know, enhance, I guess, the experience. Gameplay, 7 out of 10. Like I said, it's fun and challenging, but it could do with a little more direction. It's a little difficult to know what you should be working towards in terms of buildings at any given time unless you've played it before. So... It could use a little bit more direction, but other than that, it's pretty fun. The settings depth is 7.5 out of 10. There's no graphic settings or key bindings, but it doesn't really need them. You can't really make pixel graphics better or worse, and it's all controlled by the mouse, so... I think there are macros, like hotkeys or whatever, but I never ended up using them. There's no volume slider for sound, just the toggle, so only half points there. No resolution options, but it does have a button to switch between full screen and windows, so half points there as well, leading to the final score, like I said, 8.625 or 9 out of 10, which is 4.5 stars. So like I said, this game's on sale. If you like the idea of it, go pick it up, because it's only 80 cents. And the link, as always, will be in the description. And also, as always, if you guys have any suggestions for games you'd like to see reviewed, or suggestions for how I could improve this series, let me know in the comments. Other than that, hopefully you guys all enjoyed this, and I'll see you all next time.